Robert back here. Welcome to another edition of the Coffee Challenge. Across this field, right up through them trees. Camera caught it. There went a rabbit. We're back here at my little secluded spot. Those ivy's all about dried up. All right, let's set up the tree table. I'm not sure if this is going to work or not, but I'm going to try my tree table a different way. Put these two little trees here side by side. Or, I guess that's a prong tree, that's one tree. But I'm going to try to attach my tree table right there because that would be the perfect spot for me. Everything packed out in my small East German rain tree pattern pack. Perfect size pack for this little day pack. Dug out my old stainless steel tree table that I had years ago, and I redesigned it the way I had in my last panel one. This is much more compact, just as sturdy, it's thinner, but it's heavy duty, and I really like this table now with this new design, the straps, and the way it looks through the tree. I like it much better. That's gonna do the trick. Fairly sturdy. Said I got it on a forked tree. Strap up the top. Actually, on this forked tree, I wouldn't have needed that top strap. I could have just tied off the support strings from the front to the individual trees. So we'll do that next time. Anyway, I'm tickled the way it's working. So this is thin stainless steel. Much less bulky than my lattice one. Takes up less room in the backpack and works just as well, if not better. Okay, my bag. My little kettle. Show that in a better light in a few minutes. I'm gonna get this stove out. Got my alcohol in it. There's my Optimus Ador. Get rid of this battery powered light. preheating the Optimus Ador, denatured alcohol. Got the Bernie Dog silent burner cap on there so we can enjoy the sounds of nature. Have my regular flame spreader there laying on the back of the lid. Beautiful stove right here. Like it. Very little sound. I can hear the crickets, the katydids, frogs. Got my little excursion lantern hanging from my phone holder, camera holder. Okay, inside my little kettle. Filter bags. Coffee. I dropped it. Creamer and sugar. And a collapsible cup. Have my tree table perfectly level. It will still do the tree. Just be careful because that optimus is really slippery on the bottom on that stainless steel. I've already got my creamy sugar in my cup. Got my coffee in the filter bag ready to go. Waiting on that water to warm up and we'll get back with you. Like I said, beautiful little Optimus. Had this in a few years, I don't use it much. I've got an old, my first original Optimus. It's rusted up a little bit. That's my go-to. I usually take most of the time. But I had this cool little kettle I want to use with this one. Boiling, but I can hear the simmer. It's already steaming for our coffee. So take coffee seat just a minute. I'm gonna heat that water up a little more. I'm gonna have some grits. Collapsible bowl. I know some of y'all won't get upset instant grits. I think Mike would approve of these instant grits, Carolina crisp. I know Mike wouldn't. He likes to cook his longer than what people say you cook them. Mike's Wild Outdoor. I'm hungry this morning, so let's do 2 packs. Right, sounds like that water's to a rolling boil. Just guess at this. Tell you what, Mike, next time I go to the store, I'll buy some real grits for you. Tad bit more water. Might work. Butter. I'm gonna try to do it the way you Southern boys do. Up here, we generally eat a little butter and sugar on our grits. I think down there, you just put a little butter and some hot sauce, so I'm going to follow y'all's lead and see what that's all about. I've done that once before. It wasn't too bad. I'm going to try it again and just get a second opinion. Add a bit more water. Mule sauce. Sorry, Chris. Y'all think that's enough? I don't usually do that. I don't know. Toast. Multi-tool. Ain't like it. A little butter on that while it's hot. go. Turn this stove off, conserve fuel. Alright. Stir up that hot sauce in there. Probably could have used a little more water in there. I didn't measure, I just guessed. A little thick. Hey, I can do that. Not too bad out here in my little section of the woods. Alright, this cup's gonna go to somebody. Mike. He's the one I seen eating these grits the other day, making the grits out in the woods. So, of course, his weren't instant. But, Mike, this cup's for you, buddy. If I get your channel name wrong, please forgive me, but I think it's Mike's Wild World. Mike's Wild World Outdoors, maybe. I'm bad with channel names. I'm lucky to remember somebody's name. Yeah, that's all part of getting old. Anyway, I'll try to put a link in the description with his actual channel name. His name is Mike. So, this one's to you, Mike. Alright, I'm going to sit here and enjoy the sound of nature. Eat my breakfast. We'll talk to y'all later. Y'all know the routine. Like, share, subscribe. God bless. Okay, just a quick update. I carry this little piece of cork. I put it on top of my stove because I don't want to scuff it up when I put it in the bag, and I set my kettle on top of it. I use that cork for a cushion in between the kettle and the stove while I'm packing. But got to thinking, hey, look, that's perfect on that stainless steel tree table. The metal don't rub against the metal. And it holds on there a lot easier because I was worried I was going to slide it off because it was so slippery. But man, that does a trick right there. So I'll have to remember that next time. Just another friendly reminder. You pack it in, you pack it out. Not some of it, all of it. Like a water bottle, a grits bag, a coffee bag. Whole 9 yards, it all comes back out with you.